Hey there. Before you begin creating our invoice in Excel, if you want to save yourself a little bit of time while also supporting this channel, you can go to my Etsy store and purchase a digital download of the invoice that we'll be creating in this tutorial. You'll find a link to it in the description to this video. To start, I'm going to switch my view to page layout view, and you'll find this in the view tab of your ribbon in the workbook view section, and I'm just going to click on page layout. Now, this isn't necessary, but I do like using this page layout view because I think it's just the easiest way to see where the page boundaries are. And also, just as an FYI, I'm using Calibri font. You can see this up here. It's my default font and one that is easy to read. I prefer to use common, easy to read fonts. Doing this reduces the chances that if your recipient doesn't have the same font or an almost identical one installed on their computer, your layout might break on their screen when they open it. So this is just a personal choice for me and what we're going to be using to build this invoice. And then also my default font size is a 12-point font, but of course we'll be reformatting a few items here and there just so that they stand out a little bit more, but 12 point is my default. So with that out of the way, let's start building the invoice. There are a few key things that should be in every invoice, and one of these is, of course, communicating that this is an invoice. So in cell A1, I'm going to write the word invoice in all caps and really big. And by really big in this example means a 60-point font. And just to make it look just a little different, I'm going to change this to Calibri Light. So next, we'll skip a row, and in cell A3, we'll write the name of the business. So just write your business name. This is where you'll enter that. We'll bold this and we'll make this just slightly larger at a 14-point font. And below it, we'll enter the business's contact information. So your business may have more or less items listed than what I'm doing here, but the idea is that here's where your contact information will be found. So common items include mailing address, city, state, zip, phone number, email address, website address, professional license numbers, etc. Below it, I'm skipping a row and beginning in cell A10, I'm going to write in bold and 14-point font, Bill 2. And then the rows below that, I'm going to enter the client's billing information. So the information available to you might be different, but the idea is that this is where the client being invoiced will be identified. So I'm going to include the client's name, followed by their mailing address, phone number, and email. And again, the information you use can vary based on your business and your client. So I'm going to double click here just between columns A and B, just to expand column A. So moving to the right-hand side of the sheet, I'm going to come to cell C3. And I'm choosing C3 so that it's lined up with this first set of data that lists our business name. And here, I'm going to start entering the relevant invoice information. So in cell 3, I'll write the first item, which will be invoice number, followed by invoice date, invoice amount, terms, and due date. And now I'm going to select all of them, bold them, and I also want to right align them. And you can find that in your home tab in the alignment section. And just to the right of that, you would put in, of course, what that information is. So you would put in your invoice number, the date that the invoice was generated, the invoice amount. We're going to leave that blank for now. The terms, I'm going to use a net 30 for this example. So for the due date, you could manually type the due date, which is 1/31/2024, or you could insert a formula that just says equals the invoice date plus 30, and we of course get the same date of January 31st. Next, below these in cell C10, to line up with the bill to header, I'm going to do a label for remit to. And like with bill to, this is already bolded, but I'm going to make this a 14 point font. And this is where you're going to detail how your client will send you the funds to pay for the invoice. For this example, we'll just leave an area for the company's name and mailing address. But this could also include a link to a payment website and instructions on how to use that website, a QR code so that they can scan to go to the payment portal and pay you, or just whatever method your business has for accepting payments. And below this, we'll create an area where we can detail what is being invoiced. So in this example, I'm going to select a range of 4 columns and 13 rows. That is roughly big enough to contain both a decent number of line items and takes up a good amount of space on the invoice sheet to avoid there just being too much blank space. And in the Home tab, in the Style section, I'm going to click Format as Table. And here you have several different table styles you can select from and pick whichever one you like best or one that you think matches your business brand the most. And by the way, if you want to learn how to set up a brand-specific color palette in Excel, I do have a tutorial that you can watch on that, and I'll make sure to link that in the description of this video. So I'm going to go with one of the light ones that doesn't have banded rows, just in case that a client wants to print this. I'd rather not use up too much of their ink. And again, that's just a personal preference for me, but obviously choose the one that you like best. Selecting that, I'm going to click on my table has headers and click OK. And then I'm going to come back up here under the table design tab and uncheck filter button. And this table design tab, this is something that will only show up if your active cell is within a table. So if I move my active cell out of the table, that tab disappears. If I put it back in the table, it comes back. So next, I'm going to enter the headers that I want to use. So for me, these will be description, unit price, quantity, and total. You may need different headers, but these are just some common ones. And we're going to center these. Then under the description, this is where you list the item or the service that you're invoicing. So for this first example, I'm going to invoice a service of offering Excel help. You, of course, may have a widget, whether physical or digital. Either way, you would just list it here. And for the unit price, because this is a service, my unit price is actually my hourly fee. And the quantity is the number of hours that I'm invoicing at that fee. And let's apply accounting formatting to both the unit price and the total columns. And let's center the column for the quantity inputs. You know what? Let's do a second example. In this second example, let's invoice for an invoice template. Now, this is a digital product. And so the unit price in this example, instead of using the hourly rate, of course, we would use the price of each one of those digital downloads. And let's say that the quantity sold is 1. Then the total column will, of course, calculate the unit price times the quantity. Now, because this is a table, if I simply multiply the unit price times the quantity, that's going to populate the formula all the way down that column. But I actually don't want to have that. Just visually, I just don't want to see dollar signs in a row that's otherwise empty. So I'm actually going to use an if function for this. So we'll write equals if, open parentheses, quantity. And also, because I have this area on my sheet formatted as a table, I'm able to reference the table headers. Now, if yours is not formatted as a table, you could just reference the cell address and it'll do the same calculations. So if quantity is greater than 0, then we can multiply the unit price times the quantity. And otherwise, if that value is false and the quantity is blank or 0, Then I'll just type in two quotation marks so it'll leave that cell blank. So now, even though that formula is present in every cell of the total column, it'll only display if there's a value greater than zero in the quantity column. Take a look. We can just plug in some dummy values here to test it. So like we did before, let's expand all of these columns. So selecting all of the columns, click anywhere between the column labels at the top. And this pushed our invoice just a bit beyond the single page. So let's go into the page layout tab and click on the arrow to open up the page setup options. And let's set this to fit to one page. And let's go back into it real quick to double check that the shrinkage isn't too bad. And at 96%, I'm okay with this. And let's left align where it says remit to. Below the table, in these last columns, we're going to add some final calculations. And the first item will be subtotal. And let's undo that because I didn't want that to auto-populate as part of the table. Just clicking Control Z will remove that action of combining it into the table. The subtotal, this is going to sum all the line items in the total column. I'm using the keyboard shortcut of Alt equals to auto sum everything above it. And I want to format this with an accounting format. Below that, I'm going to enter a line item for the tax. And I'm going to display what that tax is, which in this example will be 6%. And the formula here will be the subtotal times 6%. Now you might have additional line items, say you have delivery, service charge, etc. But for this example, we're stopping at tax. So then we need a line to display the total amount due. This will be the sum of the subtotal plus any additional amount sum. And I'm just going to select these two cells and press enter. And let's bold these. And I want to right adjust them. And then the amount due, I want this bolded also. The amount due, I'm going to make this just a little bit of a bigger font. And I'm also going to go back up here where we have the field for invoice amount, and I'm going to reference that amount due. Now below all this, I'm going to skip a row, and in cell 34A, I'm going to type a heading for notes. And I'm going to bold this, and then across this page, I'm going to select cells A34 to D34. And I want to make a line underneath it. So in the Home tab, in the Font section, come to the Borders and select Bottom Border to create that effect. So this is an area that you can use for any fields that might be important to the processing of the invoice. So you could have something like the date that it was processed. You could maybe do a field for who processed the invoice, just anything that's important to your business for invoice processing. So just to do a little more customization, and this is going to be up to you how you want to do it, I'm actually going to select everything. And I want to change my font color to a dark green to resemble Excel. I'm also going to change the fill of this header to match my brand colors. So I'm actually going to come to more colors, and here on the custom tab, you can enter either your RGB color code or, like, I know what the hex code is. So I'm going to enter that for the yellow that I like using. And that makes it a little more on brand for me. And then we can see what this looks like if we try to print it. And don't forget that you can also purchase this on my Etsy shop. It's pre-made for you, so it's a great way for you to save time and help support this channel. And of course, thanks for watching. And for more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.